Dear colleagues, I've been asked to discuss about the need or rationale for crafting an autograph that is completely dangerous situations. I'm going to start with a caveat that this certainly applies only to major bone grafting situations, not the minor bone grafts you see for to threat exposures, etc. And also, this is going to look at a fixed solution for life situations and not over danger options. So I come from far away from Chennai in India. We boast of having given the world two of the most ancient languages, Sanskrit and Tamil. When something new happens, we need to watch out when something new happens. But luckily today for us, we have an option of looking at evidence from literature. And we've got these levels of evidence that you see from level one, which is systematic reviews of randomized controlled trials, highest level of evidence you can get, up to the level five, which is basically like case reports, etc. So when you look at anything that you want to do new, please look and sift through this level of evidence. In the maxilla, let me give you an answer before you and I justify it. Graftless solution is a treatment of choice. How did this become possible? Because of paradigm shifts in treatment options, such as using tilted implants, using remote anchorage, using shorter implants, narrower implants, guided surgery, to name a few. You're not familiar with this option of tilted implants, which is a hollow flow situation. Is there evidence for it? I think there's enough and more evidence for this. Convincing evidence over the last 10 years, large number of studies, publications. And you can see a CSR of almost 98-99%, very high success rates. What about remote anchorage? Again, the classical example is use of zygomatic implants. In conjunction with anterior implants, if you have reasonable amount of bone in the anterior zone 1. And if you do not have enough bone in the anterior zone, then you can use a bilateral double zygoma and still get away without any grafting, which these were being typical graft situations in those days, early days. Is there support for zygomatic implant in the literature? Yes, many, many reports. Again, long-term reports, nearly 20-year reports are there with very high cumulative survival rates and success rates. So people who have doubted zygomatic implants, there's evidence to show that this works over a long period of time. Let's take a step back. What did we do in days when we did not have these options? Of course, we did grafting. We did bilateral sinus lifts, we did on-leg grafts, etc. Why don't we do that now? Because it's long-term follow-up, more than 12,000 implants, systematic reviews. There is a good survival rate, but certainly not in the high rate of what you saw earlier. And you also have issues that you can only delay placement and also delay loading. So you're going to go through a long time frame. So much so, the consensus conference we visited in 2016 had this to say: the sinus grafting is best considered for partially dangerous situations. What about other options such as on-leg grafts, interposition? And then, of course, you need to wait for 5 to 6 months before you can place the implants and load them. Advantage is that you don't have such mobility. And then you go ahead with your conventional follow-up for procedure and place the implants and then restore them. Now, in summary for the matter, if you have more than 6 millimeters bone and more than 3 millimeters bone in the foramen region, you can still be graftless. If you have more than 6 millimeters but less than 3 millimeters in the foramen region, look at an alternative option of graftless nerve reposition. If you have less than 6 millimeters, you look at an option of graft. Now, having said that, what does the evidence tell us more? Are there some challenges when you look at evidence-based medicine? One is certainly the huge volume of literature, and it's getting more and more, and how you get the right information yourself. That's really a challenge. Then comes the challenge of how do you extrapolate the population evidence for individual benefit? Sometimes individuals, you need to treat them as an individual. You can only use the population evidence as a guidance. Now, based on this, there were a couple of very interesting papers where there was much disaccord where you would normally graph. Then they said, use tilted implants in what's called a V4 configuration, tilt all the four implants, not just the posterior implants. And talk them correctly, and have less risk of fracture. One more interesting concept that came about was using a reconstruction plate simultaneously when placing the implant, so that you strengthen the bone and reduce the chances of a fracture. Now, having said this, we have to understand that situations like this are not common. It's a minimum, maybe 2%, 3%, 5%, we don't know yet. Predominantly, most of the situations you can get away with grafted solutions. But it's a small number that may need grafting. You need to understand grafting is an option, but you're also coming across certain